suicide, did Michael Jackson fake his death to save his life? Elbow Grease Productions, in association with MichaelJacksonInsider.com, presents... So, B. Howard, how are you?
I'm great. How are you doing today?
Now, I know you're an international singing sensation, right? So, tell me how you got into singing. I know your background. Mm-hmm. You are the son of Mickey Howard. Love Under New Management. Yeah. That was the sister anthem. Like, things are going to be changing around here. Mm-hmm. So, tell me how old you were when you first started singing.
Well, I first started singing and stuff. Everything pretty much was like around, like when I was 3 or 4, and I like bang on the drums like in my mother's shoeboxes, like, you know, with that, and I'd like hear sounds and everything, and I'd sing it, and you know, like that for a long time.
Now, also caravans, isn't that?
Oh yeah, that's my grandma.
That's your grandma.
Yeah.
So you come from a singing tradition.
Oh yeah, mm-hmm. all the way.
All the way. Mm-hmm. And now you are embarking on a solo career.
Mm-hmm.
And you've launched it in Asia?
Yes, it was first place.
And you just got back from an Asian tour?
Yeah, I actually got, just recently I got back from Hong Kong, actually.
And how was that?
It was a lot of fun. I did my shows and everything like that. And, you know, they gave me a helicopter, you know, to go around and check things out. It was cool.
It was cool?
Yeah, it wasn't too bad.
So did you perform?
Yeah, I performed.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and it was just like everybody... It's like so polite over there, and they're like really cool. And like you, like it was different because Japan, everybody speaks Japanese and everything, but they speak a few English. In Hong Kong, they speak the language, but they speak English. And when you're around, if they don't know that you speak Hong Kong or Mandarin or anything like that or Cantonese, they will speak English even to each other.
Oh, it's just polite.
Like so polite, it is.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Yeah, I loved it there. It was really nice. Yeah.
So now you're embarking on. Launching your career here in America, back home.
Yeah, coming back home.
And you have a smash new hit that's on iTunes.
Yeah, it's on iTunes.
Called?
It's called Dance For It.
And tell me about that.
Well, Dance For It is like, it was a great piece that we put together with myself, Sidney Miller, and, you know, Questlove on the drums, James Poyser, you know, those guys are from the Roots. And Benjamin Wright, who was actually, you know, a string arranger for, like, you know, all Thriller and all of, like, Justin Timberlake for Christina Aguilera. He's, like, off the charts. He's from Disney. Like, I've known him since I was a kid. Like, I was just so happy to put this together, you know. It was great.
Now, when I saw your video, I was so excited. It brought back that Michael Jackson excitement for me. And, you know, of course, I'm older than you. Michael's a little bit older than me, too, but... it brought back that excitement, and I thought, he's just like Michael.
Uh-huh.
Now, I know that a lot of people compare you with Michael Jackson, and some of the fans actually think you're Michael's secret son.
Really, huh?
Yeah, that's a rumor going around.
Really?
Well, your voice, your mannerisms, the way you move, the way you sing.
Really?
Yes, really.
Okay. Yes, I knew you had another song. Yes, I did.
So, are they right, or?
Well, my bio, you can just check it out. and I was raised with the family and they took care of me since I was a kid.
Now, I know that Joe Jackson was your mom's manager at one time.
Yes, yes, he was.
And what years were there those?
Oh, wow.
You remember?
For a little while, it was before I was born.
It was before you were born?
Yeah, yeah, mm-hmm. He always says, you know, he used to play, give your mother money to buy you milk and all that stuff. Uh-huh. Funny, yeah.
Uh-huh. And didn't your mom do a duet with Jermaine to you?
Yes, yes, a song called Make It Easy on Love. Great, great, great song, great performance. You know, it was a good time. It was fun. It was, God, it was, man, it was so much fun here and stuff.
Okay, now the new song, Dance Floor.
Yes.
200,000 hits in 24 hours. Mm-hmm. I release a lot of videos on YouTube, and if I make 2,000 or 3,000 in a day, I feel like I'm just victorious. Mm-hmm. 200,000 views. I mean, what does that mean to you as an artist?
It means that I got a lot of work to do, and you know, it's gosh, it's like, it's comforting, it's good, it's nice, but we got to push harder. 300,000 is nice. You got to set the mark higher. Keep on pushing. And that's what my mother and everybody else, you know, Shaka and Jermaine and Jackie and everybody, like the whole family, like everybody instills. There's a mark. That's good. You start that mark. Go higher. You know, Legendary has already been done. What's next?
Now, you're mentioning a lot of the Jacksons. Did you stay at the house in Havenhurst? Or?
Yeah, yeah, I stayed there and stuff. You know, my mom, and they would take me over there on the weekends and some summers and stuff like that. And, you know, we all, you know, stayed a tight niche, you know, tight niche together. And it was very, it's cool, you know?
Mm-hmm. Now, I heard that you were at the house when the announcement was made that Michael had died.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. It was a you know, hard day. Mm-hmm. Hard day, but you know, I'm not one to, you know, as far as when people pass on, I don't think people are actually dying. I think people, you know, the energy is just transferred from one entity to the next, and you just spread, and you're still here.
Well, you know, it looks like Michael's energy has transformed into you.
Wow.
Because, and I'm sincere. When I watched your video, Dance Floor, and I'm not just saying this, I really got that thriller excitement. You know, when I was a teenager and Michael came on the scene, it was, you know. Yeah. All he had to do was do like this and you just die and faint. And you have that same charisma, you know. Are there more, what else is coming out for B. Howard? I know Dance Floor has just hit the scenes, it's just now cracking and doing what he's doing. But what are some of your future goals as well?
I'll tell you this, well, as far as the music goes, you think he's going one way, watch. You'll be so surprised, like it's going to be like freaking amazing, it's like epic. It's going to be crazy.
It's going to be crazy.
Yeah, but on my personal side, what I like to do is, of course, when I was coming up, you know, I was in a single parent family. You know, my mom was, you know, she was at home, you know, by herself for the most part. And, you know, I want to set up a foundation for, you know, kids that grew up like me, that single parent families. And also, you know, kids that, you know, they were kind of, you know, like, you know, when I was growing up, I used to get, you know, my mom had a lot of pressure. And a lot of, you know, things going on in her life, and her ex-husband was abusing her. So that kind of abuse kind of trickled down to well, me in particular, you know, I used to, you know, get, you know, hit on and stuff like that, you know. But I want to set up something for those kids like me, you know, that grew up in that kind of environment and still can press on and still moving forward.
So you're charitable.
Yeah, and for example, when I did the one of the World Cup songs called Kanako on the Sony album, you know, what I did is I donated all my proceeds. Yeah, my proceeds to Alicia Keys Make-A-Wish Foundation, because, yeah, I love Alicia Keys. I love what she's doing, and I think, you know, she's actually a genuine person to me that's trying to do something positive. I thought that was good, especially in South Africa. I think that was beautiful.
Millions believed Elvis did it. But did Michael Jackson really do it? Fake his death. Alive. Is Michael Jackson really dead? Investigative journalist Pearl Jr. uncovered the facts in the 2005 trial. Now she's uncovered the most shocking true story of our lifetime. Alive. Is Michael Jackson really dead? This promises to blow your mind.